led to believe, perhaps. I mean, I think it's hit and miss. Some people just get away with it completely, but I was certainly absolutely knocked out last Friday. But by 11 o'clock at night, I was fine. It took that long.
You've also got to think, if that's what the side effects are like, what would the real thing be?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, we're live on YouTube now. Good morning, everybody. Where is the camera?
Good morning.
Thanks for joining us. It's great to see you again. I don't know whether to speak to the camera or speak to the microphone at the moment. I'm in new environs. I'm all confused. I don't know.
Yeah, it's fine. It's our end.
Yeah.
We can hear you. Yeah.
We can
good.
Hear you well.
Good, good. Well, thanks for tuning in again. Thanks for joining us. It's lovely to see everybody here. We've just had some great news. Not only is Denise recovering very well, but it's also Harry's birthday on Tuesday.
Yeah.
Good old Harry. Good old Harry.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you so much.
Will you be spending most of it in the living room, or?
Probably. Yes, probably.
Probably.
We do about 20 minutes exercise up and down the drive. Yeah.
Anyway. So you'll be going out then?
Yeah. We might get in the garden, you don't know.
Oh, give over.
It was to sit outside.
I cut the lawns last week.
Yeah, I did.
Ooh, that's a bit early, Harry.
Yeah, well, I mean, awesome. It was a nice day.
Collected the beans today. Sunday, mine,
and they've actually emptied the green bins today.
Yes, ours emptied. Yeah.
Fantastic.
And it was full as well.
Morning, Christine. Have you just joined us? Can you hear us?
I thought I wasn't allowed in today. Somebody's got me slot.
Look, I saw you. You stood there in the lobby.
So, are you any better today, Paul?
I am well. Chris is well, and Denise is well. We're all well.
Oh, good.
Well.
How about you, Harry and Mo?
We're fine.
You're
just missing to Harry, so because it's his birthday on Tuesday. So I'm afraid you're on your own, Christine.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Harry. Happy birthday to you.
Fantastic. We'll have to get you doing more solos, Christine. That was nice.
I've done three this morning because I've got three good friends all on the 5th. So I've had to do it before I came here.
I see you've had it warmed up.
Yes.
Fantastic. So. Well, you should consider it as a career, maybe.
Yeah. What, a birthday singer.
Sonogram. Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah.
Harry, message for Harry.
Dings and bar mitzvahs.
That would be good.
It's what the world needs now.
That's
the song title.
Let's have a bit of warm up, shall we? Are we ready? Are we ready for this? Are we?
No.
Have we sprung into spring?
No. Yeah.
Got your skipping rope out? I say it's very good for you, actually. Yeah. Stay on your toes.
I don't do skipping, granddaughter.
Remember French skipping? French skipping was one of those women's mysteries that I never...
Yeah.
Oh, it was...
Plastic.
Yeah. Would you like that?
I didn't have a skirt I could tuck into my belt, so I was underdressed.
Chinese?
What did you do for Chinese?
Chinese, that was elastic bands.
Oh, yeah.
that was wrapped around somebody else's ankle, you know, two, and then somebody in the middle.
Yeah.
It was Chinese.
Yeah. And there are all kinds of rhymes, weren't there?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, Larry.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. You did it, Larry. You did it,
yeah.
Just deep breath in and hold it. Let it go. Same thing, breathing in. Hold it. Let it go. This time or not or no. Breathing in. Nice. Chris, would you lead us in a major scale, please?
I will certainly try. 2, 3, 4.
I've got a new setup in the new room here, so I the old fingers aren't quite. I've got to press things that I didn't used to have to press. So.
Oh yes.
With all that R-ing, it's put me in the mood for a wee bit of.
Yes.
Oh yes. No.
Lights are low, looking out for a place to go, where they play the right music, getting in the swing, you're in the mood for a king. It's too low, I've got to go.
Anybody could be that guy, night is young and the music's high, where's the mouse gone? With a bit of rap music, everything is fine. You're in the mood for a dance. And when you get the chance, you are the dancing queen. Young and sweet, only 17. Dancing queen, feel the beat from the tambourine.
still not worked. Go on, why not? Oh dear, oh dear. Oh, I'm gonna have to get a mouse out at this rate. Are you there?
Yes.
Really, oh, mother?
Yeah. Yeah. Apologize. This is gonna take a little bit of a while to get used to this. I'm on the laptop again, so.
Yes.
Where there's usually a mouse and everything, I've just got this wee little pad. It's a bad workman who blames his tools, though. Hey, speaking of workmen and tools, I remembered a brilliant song from my childhood, which I haven't sung for years and years and years, that I thought would be rather fun to do today. Where has it gone? There it is.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, that's better. Chris, I can hear you. I can't hear
Do you fancy it, Chris?
I don't know it will.
I'll give it a go.
We fancy it.
Cool. Here we
yes.
go.
Yes.
No, that's not me. It's not everyone. That's done something totally entirely different. Hang on. Oh dear, oh dear. It used to be that I could just literally click the keyboard and you would all be silenced immediately. I've never had such power.
It was disappear.
But, right, if I press that, maybe.
But if you can't do it, we'll just mime.
Yeah.
It might be that I have to mute you and then share for some reason. There we go. Ha-ha! It's just me now. Fantastic. Okay, well, there we go. Right, said Fred. Right, said Fred, both of us together, one each end and steady as we go. Tried to shift it, couldn't even lift it, we was getting nowhere, and so we had a cup of tea. And right, said Fred, give a shout for Charlie, up comes Charlie from the floor below. After straining, leaving and complaining, we was getting nowhere, and so no, it's not right. I've gone too late, too quickly, haven't I? And so we had a cup of tea, and Charlie had a think, and he thought we ought to take off all the handles and the things what held the candles. But it did no good, well, I never thought it would. All right, said Fred, have to take the feet off, get them feet off, wouldn't take a mo. Took its feet off, even took the seat off, should have got us somewhere, but no. So Fred said, let's have a cup of tea, and we said, righto. That's more or less it, isn't it? That's where it goes. All right, said Fred, have to take the door off, need more space to shift the so-and-so. Had bad twinges, taking off the hinges, and it got us nowhere, and so we had a cup of tea, and right, said Fred, have to take the wall down, that there wall is gonna have to go. Took the wall down, even with it all down, we was getting nowhere, and so we had a cup of tea, and Charlie had a think, and he said, look, Fred, I've got a sort of feeling, and if we remove the ceiling with a rope or two, we could drop the rider through. All right, said Fred, climbing up a ladder with his crowbar, gave a mighty blow. Was he in trouble? Half a ton of rubble landed on the top of his dome. So Charlie and me had another cup of tea, and then we went home. I said to Charlie, we'll just have to leave it standing on the landing, that's all. You see, the trouble with Fred is, he's too hasty. Never get nowhere if you're too hasty.
Oh,
lovely.
Boom, boom.
think that meant.
And a cribbins, wasn't it? Yeah.
It was.
Yeah, funny.
Does it make you think of Fred Dibley, that?
Dibner. Fred Dibner.
Yeah, that's his name. Yeah.
Chimney man.
There was a sort of rash of those, wasn't there? Sort of songs in that sort of era. Come Outside was one I remember.
Oh, it's Mike Sarn. Yeah. Dreadful song. Mike Sarn and Wendy Richard.
Wendy Richards.
That's it. It was
awful. Off EastEnders.
Yeah.
But then there was that man who called himself Right Said Fred, who did I'm Too Sexy for
Yes. Fashion. Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember hearing that for the first time. I was driving down to the South Coast. We were on the way to holiday. And in fact, I was on my own. I was meeting people. And that came on the radio. Right Said Fred, the first one, I'm Too Sexy. I just thought, that is number one straight away. And it was. it's not often I'm right in my predictions, but it was. I just thought, that is straight number one, surely. And it was. Very good.
It is.
Very funny.
So I've only got one other song prepared, guys, today, but I don't want to hog the limelight here. I've done two in a row already.
I think you do a third one.
We'll look.
Yeah. Oh, go on if you insist. All right, so apologies if you can't read this. The scan wasn't quite as good. Can you see those lyrics there?
Yeah.
The font's a bit odd.
Yeah, it's sort of it's an oldie worldie font, and the scanning resolution is not quite as high as I would have liked it to have been. So this is that song that I mentioned last week about the lady I met in Cornwall who had the medals that were given to her father-in-law about the ploughing.
It's called the
Somerset Ploughman. It's cut off at the top there. You can't see it, but that there's the chorus. I'll start with the chorus, so you'll at least get a chance to sing the chorus a couple of times.
Right.
Okay. Without much more ado, I'll play this song for you. And yeah, I think I can. Yeah, that should be okay. He was the last of an ancient dynasty to work with team and plough. A master at hand with the horse and the land, he's in greener pastures now. Herbiorg born his name, who a legend became, earned his fee in the fields all day. From Red Hill to Rington, from Lulsgate to Lye, working in the Somerset way. His grandfather John and the praise of the king, a master craftsman recognized. For ploughing a furrow so perfectly formed underneath the clear blue sky. He was the last of an ancient dynasty to work with team and plough. A master at hand with the horse and the land, he's in greener pastures now. From morn till night, he would follow behind, ploughing rows so straight and true, turning fields of green into furrows of brown, and changed the landscape's hue. The majesty of the heavy horse, a sturdy and a well-feathered shire. In winter would sow, and in summer would mow, to the headland from the byre. He was the last of an ancient Fashion Dynasty, to work with team and plough. A master at hand with the horse and the land, he's in greener pastures now. The, bear with me, you can't see the last line, and I'm gonna have to extend that down. I can't do it, bear with me, there it is, I've got it now. There we go. The brass hangs proud on the old parlour wall, with trophies and photographs too. Though the horses and harness are all long gone, their ghosts never fade from view. Now time's moved on and the ploughing's done by tractor where his shires once roamed. He rests at last, his day has passed, and they've found their harvest home. He was the last of an ancient dynasty to work with team and plough. A master at hand with the horse and the land, he's in greener pastures now. He was the last of an ancient dynasty to work with team and plough. A master at hand with the horse and the land, they're in greener pastures now. There we go.
That's beautiful.
Nice, that's
beautiful. Yeah. Yeah, Di Franklin is the name of the lady who wrote it. And she was married to, I think it was Herbie's grandson.
Gosh, it's lovely.
But you can see why I thought of it. You guys were all talking about the brass when you were getting married or whatever.
Yeah.
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 Well, he had the real thing.
Yeah. We've mentioned a ton of a stockbroker before, and he does one called Cheering the Plough.
Yeah.
Some similarities, yeah.
I have to look that one up.
He's a very busy boy at the moment. I get his Facebook feed and he's he's doing all sorts.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Taylor the stockbroker.
Yeah.
He's a wonderful one called Old Teenagers.
That sounds we're old teenagers.
Yeah. Sounds like us, doesn't it? And it's called what? Speed the Plough, did you say? Speed the Plough.
Cheering the Plough.
Cheering.
Where are we now? Cheering the Plough. He does lots of political ones, which are excellent.
He does.
Right. Grand.
But he's also he's very into his early music.
Yes.
We saw him just before, it must have been about a month. In fact, it was his last gig.
Oh.
I remember him because he posted on it at Hagler's Corner in Sheffield. And it was his last gig before lockdown. And he came equipped with a variety of exotic sort of early music instruments.
All right.
I think he had
sackbuts and the
like. Yes, I think there was a sackbut in there, possibly. There was certainly some very odd stuff. Patagonian nose flute and what have you.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think there was a Patagonian nose flute.
I don't leave the house without a Patagonian nose.
No. But yeah, it was very good.
Chris, do you want to choose one from our recent editions?
From the recent editions, yeah. I've been very tempted to go off piece, and I'm just seeing if I can get the technical.
Do it.
I've got Google at the ready if we can look up some quick links.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, shall I tell you what I've been messing around with, and I might
what
try and
it's
I've been well I've not been messing around with what I should have been messing around with. Damien Rice, are we familiar? Are you familiar?
Yeah, man. The daughter.
No, I know the name.
Blower's daughter. Yes, the Blower's daughter. Exactly that.
I was just thinking of that the other day, thinking I haven't heard him sing that for ages.
Well, do you want to bring it up, and I will have a little dabble.
That's amazing.
I'll do the backing with it. But there's obviously it's a duet, and I haven't got the female vocal part. So if anybody knows it, they can join in virtually. I won't hear you. So I've not put anything on the. It's 8 bars, isn't it, in the middle? But anyway, okay, we'll have a look. Just a minute, let me get out of this.
I'll do the.
How do I get out of that exit full screen? Right. You found it?
Bear with, yeah. If I share...
I'm sorry, it's completely impromptu.
No, it's great. I remember the last time you sang this at Fagan's. I asked for it and you've been playing it that day.
Well, I've been messing. So I'll see if I can just... I've just done a quick... I have to share my thing, don't I? Share computer audio.
Okay. So we might I don't know how I get in there. You've just muted yourself, but...
Mute. Where's the share thing? Can't find it.
It might not
be... Oh, share... It is. I got it. Share audio anyway. Share sound. That's it. So it should.
Let's see if you can hear it. You're sharing your screen now as well.
Am I?
That means that you'll have to put up the lyrics if...
I was trying to just share sound. You're sharing sound from your computer. Stop screen sharing. I don't know. I'm confused. It's maybe not working as well as I thought.
But you've done some... You've done a track, have you?
I have. I've just quickly bounced down a track without the vocals, but okay, look, I'll bring up, if I can, I'll bring up the lyrics and then
good
we'll
man.
See.
That'll be the easiest thing.
Dog's joining in.
I tell you what, I'll come straight away if you...
There's the lyrics here, yeah. Nice. All right, what you got?
Yeah, we can see that. Can you zoom in a bit so it's a bit bigger? Yes, perfect. Good man.
I don't know if I'll be able to scroll. Maybe a bit less zoom.
Nice.
Just let me go and sort this dog out. Betty! Shut up.
You probably know it, folks, if you've... if you've not, Damien Rice, isn't he the guy who also did that song that everyone was covering on
Shut up!
Britain's Got Talent, that sort of thing.
Oh, took a lot longer than it should have done, right. Are we good?
We are good.
Let's see if I've got the audio. I'll just check, play that and see. Can you hear that?
No.
You can't.
That's a shame. Do you want to...
It says I'm sharing sound. Yeah, I'll do something else.
Oh, that's a shame. Are you playing it inside your digital audio workstation?
No, I exported it. That's why I can't understand why it's not doing it. Well, that's been a waste of 5 minutes. I'll come back to it. I'll do something else.
Okay. In fact, it is saying that you are definitely sharing your sound, so...
Yeah.
I'm being given the option to mute you, so...
That's weird.
It is weird.
Okay. Well, you know, technology.
You could give us a piano version.
I could. Or a guitar version.
Or a guitar version.
Unfortunately, I've worked very hard on it being getting the arrangements up. Okay, we'll have a go.
Cool. Can you stop your share screen?
I can if I can get right.
It's all right, I can do it, I think. I can do it.
Stop share, done it. Yeah, yeah, right, there we go.
Brilliant. Okay.
Sorry about that little diversion, folks. We're trying to work the technology that we can't get working.
Yeah, it should have worked. Sorry about that. We'll
yeah, it could. It should have worked.
That, yeah.
Can't work out why. Yeah. I'll have a look at break. And so it is, just like you said it should be. Life goes easy on me most of the time. And so it is, the shorter story. No love, no glory, no hero in her sight. I can't take my eyes off of you, can't take my eyes off you, can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes. And so it is, just like you said it would be. We'll both forget the breeze most of the time. So it is, the colder water, the blower's daughter, the pupil. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes off of you. Can't take my eyes. Did I say that I loathe you? Did I say that I want to leave it all behind? Can't take my mind off of you. Can't take my mind off you. Can't take my mind off of you. Can't take my mind off of you. Can't take my mind off of you. Can't take my mind, my mind, my mind, till I find somebody new.
Nice.
Yeah. It's a lovely song. Yeah, thank you.
Can't wait for your version to be revealed, mate. I'm sure it's
well. Out. It's good. It's better than that.
Don't worry.
No, it is good.
It, reminded me of what's that Andy Williams song? The
can't take him. Yeah, yeah. I think he's cribbed it a little bit. Yeah.
You're too good to be true.
That's the one.
Yeah, that's the one.
Don't we?
We could do that.
Yes, we could do that.
Lovely. We could that's do that.
Yeah. Isn't that one we have done before?
We have.
Yeah.
Shall we?
Lots of percussion in that one. Yeah.
Hey, Denise is ready.
No, we clean.
You're forgetting you can't see everything that I'm doing currently because I'm coming in and out of the share screen. There we go. Okay. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. And I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Sorry about all this silence at the end, generally.
That's great.
We love it, actually.
For those watching, there's generally a nice ripple of approbation at the end of all our songs, but now there's just a lot of silence while I faff.
I wanted a full drum kit for that one.
Yeah, I could see you all shaking. So it was there in my mind.
I was Saturday night, who said Andy Williams show.
Oh, yeah.
And all the top, you know, Matt Munro. We saw them all on Saturday nights. He was like, sit down and watch a great show.
Yeah.
No doing that,
really.
Yeah.
The Osmonds, didn't they?
I was thinking of, you know, more horsey songs to go with the Somerset Ploughman. And Chris, I wondered if you do Mustang Sally from The Commitments.
I can maybe have a go at that, yes, indeed.
Pretty sure being in a covers band for 20 years, you must have been asked
for might have done it once or twice, yeah.
Party, isn't it, that one?
I've done it once or twice. It's been known. I'm just wondering if the reason that my thing isn't working is apparently my computer can't find my iTunes or library, which is a bit disconcerting.
Well, it's a whole library.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, they had to burn down Alexandria. It's not like you lose it in your back pocket.
I could hear the sound. I could hear it.
Could you?
Yeah.
You could. Oh, could you hear?
It's the sound, yeah.
Oh, right. Okay. That's the thing then.
We could.
Oh, right. Oh. I wish I hadn't exposed myself so much now. It's much more comfortable with the backing, I have to say. It's a very open. Yeah. I'll rephrase that. I'll
if
get
you
my
are
cut.
Going to expose yourself, it's best to have musical backing, I agree.
Yes. Yeah, I mean,
I've just had to pay the window cleaners. He says, can we sing?
He says what?
I said, paying window cleaner. And he wanted me to sing. And I says, I don't sing. I said, but we've got one for every occasion. So he says, when I'm cleaning windows, I don't think that's low down.
Yes. Oh, yeah, that's good, that one.
George Ford.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You only know.
not one I've ever learned myself. Are you there, Chris?
I'm here, yes. Yeah, oh, right, sorry. Okay.
Oh, growling at her.
Mustang Sally. Guess you better slow your Mustang down. Mustang Sally now, baby. Guess you better slow your Mustang down.
Now, look at
Sally. Something like that.
That's some up dancing, isn't it?
What lyrics have they got in there? Now you come around signifying a woman. What's that about? I think somebody on Google Translate was having a bad day.
Craziness. Yeah, he's talking about a car, but a Mustang is a it's a wild horse, isn't it? It's
yeah.
Wild American horse.
Wild horse.
Well, yeah.
The window cleaner was having a bad day. We wanted a bacon lasagna. I've got no bread and I've got no wraps. And no time.
Did he ride on?
Yeah. Not very early.
I am ready. Prostitutes, I need it, but I ain't got any. It's empty. he'll get one somewhere. Somebody will take pity on him.
There's a lovely Stone song, which Subo made popular.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Horses.
Great song. There's one in there. We could do that.
Let's give it a go.
If you can bring the lyrics up.
Can I bring the lyrics up, he says. I think I've been idle.
Oh, yeah, that one, yeah.
You're slightly loud, Chris. You're just clipping ever so slightly.
Okay. Let's just take the master down a bit.
It's not that.
No, I didn't.
Let's try that. Why? And though I am excited, sorry, all of stage lines make me feel bitter. I'll treat you unkind. Wild horses couldn't drag me away. Wild horses couldn't drag me to dog accompaniment and frog in throat. I'm just going to go and let her out or let her in or whatever it is she's barking at, driving me up the wall. 1 second.
Wild horses couldn't.
That reminds me of the beginning of Everlasting Love. I thought it was that at first.
Words.
It's very much like that.
It reminded me of, you think that I don't even mean a single word.
Oh, yeah. That's the one.
Everlasting
love.
Everlasting love. Yeah.
Yes. Very much like it.
I've got that on my to-do list for a backing track because it's
Ronan Keating, isn't it, that one?
Yeah.
Oh, which one are we talking about?
I think it's Only Words or something like that. Or...
Yeah. That's Bee Gees words.
Bee Gees words, yeah.
Yes, Bee
Gees. Is that what you're thinking?
Well, I know a cover by Westlife or someone like that, probably.
Yeah, it's similar riff.
Yes, indeed. Or the Fortunes, what did they sing in the 70s?
Lost, oh, yeah.
In
the 70s?
Yeah.
And another 70s horse one was America, Horse With No Name.
Yeah.
Yes, I remember that. Yeah.
And then, of course, there's Father Ted.
Yeah.
Horse.
He's got his best Neil Young on here.
Yeah, I thought about that. Great deal to the tune.
Ghost riders in the sky.
Horse riders in the sky.
Ghost riders.
Yeah, ghost riders, yeah.
And you know that one, I Turn to You, that was in the charts around 2000 or something like that? I used to really annoy my stepdaughter by singing a big old song, I Turn to Glue.
You can be relied on. Someone
mentioned the Fortunes.
Me.
In the 60s, I used to work on a Saturday job as a tailor's, selling suits.
Yeah.
This guy came in, and he was John McNally, who was one, I think his name John McNally, from the Searchers. And we were talking about having a suit made because they were doing round the clubs in Sheffield.
Wow.
And, he was a really lovely man. The next time I saw him was 50 years later when we went to Butlins, and on came the Fortunes.
Yeah. Oh, my favourite.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is the suit still fitting?
I didn't have one.
I think I first saw them at the Black Swan.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Mucky Duck.
Yeah.
Mucky Duck.
Yeah.
Mucky Duck. Yeah. Yeah. I think
I still can't.
I think I'd gone on a blind date, and this one, if you sat with your back to them, you'd think it was so-and-so, and I can't remember whose name he said to me, but, I just love Fortunes in them days, 70. Yeah.
It was still good when we saw them at Buckley,
But
they were still good.
That's right.
Because they didn't need all the backing tracks and all that. They
not in those days, did they?
No.
Guys, it's... Oh, fantastic. Look at this. I was just about to get up and make a cup of tea, but one is wending its way towards me.
Well.
I have a beautiful, dutiful wife.
Oh, what are you after?
Thank you very much, darling.
It looks like high tea, that.
I nearly got it over me for the dutiful comment.
Yeah.
It's rather a long pause as she's still.
Yeah,
right, we'll go and make a brew then.
Yes, indeed.
Okay.
Lovely.
Apologies if you've been a bit stuck with. As Chris said, we did go a little bit off piste and. Yeah. You probably didn't know quite a lot of those, some of you, I'd imagine.
Oh, it's been good. Yeah. Enjoyed it.
Helen, makes a change.
Yes.
Yeah.
Good. Well, I'm glad you have been bored, at least.
Buy something.
Yeah. Helen?
Yeah.
Your scarf. I want to apologise to Chris last week because she asked him to play a Steve Earle song and I pinched it, so he should sing another one, a different one.
That's fine.
Because I picked Galway Girl and it was him that was supposed to be picking.
Oh.
Anyway, I'm going.
Oh.
Alan? Yes, Alan, your scarf's beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Your scarf, it's beautiful, yes.
It's a very special one because a friend of mine bought it for me in, I think it was in Japan when she'd gone, and it was when I'd got cancer and I was very, very poorly, And she gets altitude sickness, and she'd walked right up this mountain, and on the top of this mountain was a Buddhist temple. And to get at the top of the mountain, you still had to go up all these steps to where the statue of the Buddha was, and they were selling things up there. And she felt really poorly herself, but she said she got all the way to the top. And I've talked with my friend Jill about praying, and she's an atheist, but she believes in positive, focused thought. And I said, well, that's, you know, God sees that as prayer. He hears it in the same way. And you know, and I said that, you know, for me, all that effort she put into it and thinking about me, I said, that's a prayer for me.
Yes, and
so I always feel wrapped in her love and her prayers when I wear it. And I got better.
It's beautiful and a lovely thought.
Yeah, that's a good point, that Helen. I don't think that religion's got a monopoly on prayer, you know.
Yeah.
You don't have to be religious to pray.
I don't want to monopolise things, but it's been National Book Day yesterday, and John's daughter's little girl, Sophie, went dressed as the White Witch from Narnia because she's reading the Narnia books. The Narnia books are lovely. And there's a bit in one of the Narnia books, I think it might be The Magician's Nephew, where Aslan, the lion, who is kind of like God, is talking to somebody from a different country whose religion is different. And he said to this captain of the guard, he said, well, you were talking to me. You thought you were talking to somebody else or I'm talking to nobody, but I heard you anyway. And, you know, I think there's a lot of that in it, you know.
Yeah.
None of us understand all of this, and we don't need to.
Right. It'll all come out in the wash.
Exactly. It's just, you know, the desires of our hearts. Yes.
Yeah.
I used to have a mate called Steve. His nan was always full of, you know, kind of truisms like that, that just, you know. Bring it down to the home, really. I suppose quite a lot of her wisdom was just from what she knew about her, from what worked. You can scrub your step all you like; someone's still going to tread on it.
Yeah,
that's the kind of thing she'd say.
Well, I know I've been held in prayer a lot in the last few weeks, and it's really made a big difference to me. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really appreciate it.
Mm.
Well, we all love you, Denise.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you.
You've certainly been on our minds very much, Denise, in our conversation.
Yeah.
Well, seeing as we've mentioned cancer, I got some good news. I've only got two more treatments to go for my bladder.
Oh, that's good. Good, great.
There are great people out there, as well as people praying for you.
Yeah.
And the combined force does certainly help.
It does help.
You do feel better. And I've got this good news. I've only got two more to go.
Yeah.
Then she says, well, you've had your treatment. We just keep an eye on you.
Yeah.
I thought, well, that's wonderful.
Yeah. I mean, positive thought is a lot, I think. If people don't believe in prayer, that makes a big difference.
Yeah.
Oh, definitely.
It saves you, really, isn't it, when you think about it?
It is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we've got all the medical things for a reason. We should never, you know, not believe in those or ignore them, because they're there for a reason, and you know, they're there for our benefit, and you know, we should make the most of them. Oh. And I'm grateful that, you know, there is all that skill out there and all these wonderful scientists and NHS who do all the things that help us to keep well. So
that's right. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Talking about prayer, when we were younger, we used to go regularly to church, and you'd get the priest saying, and now we'll say a few prayers for the sick of the parish. And then we'll have a collection for the poor of the parish. And we have this big community hub in every district of the church.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's what the kind of things that they did, didn't it? Yeah. It's all gone now. Well, it's all gone a lot.
A lot of it's gone.
Yeah.
But it just brings people together, doesn't it?
Yes.
Mm. Yeah. Call the midwife days, Harry.
Sorry?
Call the midwife days.
Yes, the call of the draft is, yes.
Yeah.
It was just like that. It was, yeah.
That show, I get sucked into it every time.
I try
and avoid it because I know I'm going to cry. I try and pretend I'm busy on my phone, but I always get sucked in.
I think it's good to know what people used to, what used to happen to people, I think.
Yeah,
there's no need to wash it all away, is there? I think it's good to look back.
Yeah, of course it is.
Yeah.
We watched a programme called Made in Britain this week, and they were making various things, and they were making foils for fencing, foils.
Oh.
And they were using Sheffield steel, and they were doing them in London, and he says, well, we've got these machines, he says, and they're from the 70s, he says, and we've still got them because there aren't any other better.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the thing about it. Sometimes the old ways are the best ways.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm. I it was quite a sad thing, really. I was working as an engineer and a blacksmith over in Doncaster for a year, and we dismantled the biggest tractor gear factory in Europe. It was a place called Case, off the motorway where Harley Davidson is now.
Amazing.
And they had this enormous carburizer. If you don't know what a carburizer is, it sort of adds a layer of carbon onto metal, and like they'd cover it with carbon and they'd send it, like you're baking a cake kind of thing. Instead of putting icing on, you'd put carbon on and you'd bake the carbon, and it was called Case hardening, which is where they got the name.
Yes. Case hardening.
And we had to climb inside these ovens and clean them all out, and it was a bit like, you know, you knew what like the Victorian chimney sweeps were like, because once you were in, you were in. It wasn't like you could just back out, because there were a couple of other guys sort of either side of it. You were in there for a couple of hours at least, you know, before your cup of tea.
Yeah.
And it was hot, sweaty, dirty work.
Was it scary?
You sort of have to put that out of your mind, really. You know, if you focus on the fact that...
I'm in an oven.
You're in an oven. Yeah, I could see, you know, in your mind, you could lose it one way, but you have to sort of just crack on and think, oh, I've got to do that next.
Yeah.
But so no,
I used to be a furnace engineer down at East End, and it was part of my, you know, the various jobs that I had. And I used to go to the cathedral furnaces, what they call a cathedral, and they are big. But by golly, they hold the heat a long time. And if you have to go and examine the flow, like you say, you've got to turn your brain off, because it's...
It used to put me in a panic all the time. I used to say to him, you will tell somebody you're going in, won't you? I was genuinely petrified. I hated it.
Yes.
I thought, what if somebody doesn't know he's in?
Yeah.
They can't see you screaming.
No.
No.
Yeah. A long time ago, that.
Yes.
I'd like to go back to these places and see how they've changed. They're missing
the
carburizing plant. We had you know, oxyacetylene torches.
Yeah.
We used to call them gas axes.
Yeah.
And we chopped up these great big machines with gas axes and sent them overseas to people who don't have unions and working regulations and are much cheaper to employ.
Yes.
Which is rather sad, really.
Yeah, it is sad.
It's sad.
Oh. Yeah.
But it was it's a working man I was. I
And you survived. You got out of that oven.
It was ever such great fun. I met this chap. He was... he was a blacksmith, and I met him at sort of a summer fete type thing. And we got talking in the real ale tent, and it emerged that he was a blacksmith. And I was like, oh, I need a trivet. We used to go camping quite a lot, and I wanted something to put over a real fire so I could put a saucepan on instead of putting it directly on the fire. So I said, oh, yeah, I need a trivet. Can you make me a trivet? He said, well, why don't you come over and make it yourself?
Ooh.
Yeah, and so that sort of turned into, you know, a friendship, which turned into a job.
Wow, nice. Yeah.
That was a good year.
Well, it was amazing. Going up Abbeydale Road, because there were some little old workshops up there, weren't they? I don't know whether they're still in Sheffield Hamlet, yeah.
Yeah, and I think they've just
looking at how they used to make it, you know. Don't know if it's still there.
Yeah, they've just had some money to which they've had before, but yeah, they've had some money to sort of revamp it. But it's the fortunes of Abbeydale Hamlet go up and down, but it's always there.
Yeah,
fascinating place.
Yeah, we used to have workshops in Elsicar.
I'm going to say it's similar to it. Yeah,
they're not there now.
Not at the Heritage Centre, no.
In the Heritage Centre, we used to have a tinsmith and all different people doing lots of things.
And of course, craftsmen. And of course, we've just Stan Shaw, the last of the great little nesters, has passed away a couple of weeks ago.
That song that we did is very apt, isn't it, about the ploughman?
Yeah. Trades disappearing. Yeah.
The biggest revolution I've seen around here is the size of the tractors. They are massive.
They are enormous. That go past our house, they're like big combine harvesters. They're massive, and you think, gosh, you know, they're having to knock fences down to get them in.
You go looking back at the David Brown tractor, it was like a toy.
Yeah.
That was made at Penistone.
Oh. Yeah. I often wonder how they change a tyre on them.
Yes.
David Brown was also at Meltham, wasn't he?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah. And that's how Aston Martin used DB, isn't it?
Yeah,
because David Brown and whoever started Aston Martin.
Yes.
Yeah, and that's where the DB6 or the DB7.
Mm-hmm.
That's their logo, isn't it?
Yeah.
This programme's excellent for that, isn't it? As old as I am, and as I've known David Brown be there as long as I've been here. And
sorry, I didn't know
that little snippet at the end that Denise had just said, I didn't know. I've learned something at 80-year-old because we're all here having a good chat.
It's school day. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Right then, guys, it's request time. And as it's Harry's birthday boy, I think he should have first go.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you. Yes. Could I have Fool on the Hill? I love that one.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, 6 and 10.
I think I've got the number two, I think.
Words to that hurt. Really? Yeah. Real.
Yeah.
Assembly Village had one.
Yeah, they did, didn't they?
You know, yes.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah.
And because it was cheap, wasn't it? Yeah.
Lovely.
Mm. Down and out of the normal.
Yeah, thing, that's so. Why I take him out. Everybody knew him. Everybody knew him, you know.
Some of them have gone through trauma.
Yes.
You forget, don't you, Anna?
Just let me know if you can hear this, guys. Sorry, it's not happening yet. Oh, come on. It's the first time I've done everything on this computer, and before it plays anything, it's like, well, what piece of software would you like me to play it with? And this piece of software, there's lots of options you can have with it.
Just get on with it.
Yeah.
Well, worry about it, Paul. It's not worth worrying about.
It's not worth
having
worrying
a good
about.
Time.
Can you hear that?
Come and sit with me.
Day after day,
alone on a hill,
and with the
foolish dreams, deeper still.
Nobody wants to know him. You can see he's just a fool, and he never gets an answer.
glance up at the food on the hill, sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning round. Well, on his way, head in a cloud, and of a thousand voices talking perfectly loud, but nobody ever hears him or the sound he appears to make, and he never seems to notice. But the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head the world spinning round and round and round and round and round. Nobody seems to like him, they can tell what he wants to do, he never shows his feelings. But the sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning round. Day after day, alone on the hill, the man with the foolish grin is keeping perfectly still. But nobody wants to know him, you can see that he's just a fool, and he never gives an answer. But the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning round.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Lovely song.
Yeah.
Our friends Phil and Kath have been in touch, and they would like us to sing Shenandoah.
That was mine.
So, are you prepared for Shenandoah?
I would. Prepared maybe is trifle optimistic, but I'm good for it. Can't see it though.
Oh, sorry, bear with. I'm still faffing. Faff number two, and lastly, faff number three. There we go. I must rationalise my workflow for next week.
It's hard though with this tech, isn't it? I long to see you away, rolling river. Oh, Shenandoah, I long to see you away. I am bound away across the wide. Cross your waters.
past the wide Missouri.
To hear the choir sing that.
I know.
Well, I can't wait to hear the choir sing anything. I can't wait to be in a room with another person in real time playing music.
Yeah.
You're driving me up the wall. There you go.
Hold on. I'm not going to be
hold on. I know, hold on. I've got I know a song about that as well. There's something else I've been doing in my spare time. But
yeah.
In fact,
Denise, would you like to choose one?
Me or
you?
Me on Denise.
Can we have Yesterday, please?
Yesterday.
Yes.
Lovely.
You can have it today.
Do you prefer Chris's version of this to mine?
We've got it on track, haven't we? But anyway, yeah.
How are you doing? Do you mind doing it, Chris?
No, I don't mind doing it.
Good man.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. The man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly. Why she had to go, I don't know. She wouldn't say. Such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why she had to go, I don't know. She wouldn't say. I said something.
lovely.
Just hear lots of little coming in at different times.
Yeah. One of my Beatles.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you can't. There's, you know, there's a wealth, isn't there, of things.
Lady Madonna, we haven't done. I think.
Oh.
Yes, that's.
All right, okay, you're up for it.
Yeah.
Need some worms.
Nice one, yeah. Next week we'll have
okay.
Bernice.
Hello there.
Hello, what would you like to sing?
How about Edelweiss, please?
Oh, yeah.
That's all right, yes.
I'm game. I think you've done quite a lot in the first half while I faffed around with stuff. It didn't work.
And you, Chris, we are Bosch. Yes.
Yes. Ooh, I haven't got a key. What key would it be?
F-ish.
So A-ish, I think, yes. Probably right.
This before, but my husband had a friend who used to sing Idle Wife every morning.
I'm not going to say that somebody taught it me in German, but I'm not going to say what it sounds like.
No.
Something idle, something.
Thank you for that. I didn't sing Dee because that's her favourite, but I think it reduces her to tears when it says bless your homeland forever because she misses it so much. But
yes.
Thank you, thank you.
Pleasure.
Oh, lovely.
Lovely words, lovely song.
Christine, would you like to choose one?
Oh, yes, please. Thank you.
All right, you pop the screen up, please. Oh dear, I'm divvious. Can you talk amongst yourselves?
It's not the same one. Do you want the book one instead of book two?
No, that I'm fine with this, Paul. Thank you. Oh, Galway Bay.
Oh yeah, lovely. Oh. The proper version, though, please.
Yes.
That's one that Chris was going to learn ages ago. I don't know if he actually
did. Well, we did. Yes, we did the old.
You only know the old one, don't you, Chris?
Maybe at the coming of the day.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yes,
can we have the
moonrise over Claddagh?
Can you do one with who, Denise?
Can we have that version?
I suppose.
Yes.
Might be a bit low, that. I think I'm not. There's a little bit of a variation in here that I seem to recall that I haven't got, but we'll try it anyway. The sea to Ireland, then maybe at the closing of your day you can sit and watch the moon rise over Claddagh and see the sun go down on Galway Bay, just to hear again the ripple of the trout stream, women in the meadow making hay, just to sit beside the turf fire in a cabin and watch the barefoot gazoons as they play, or the breezes blowing o'er the seas from Ireland are perfumed by the heather as they blow, and the women in the uplands digging praties speak a language that the strangers do not know. There should be more words. If you ever go across the sea to Ireland, then maybe at the closing of your day you can sit and watch the moon rise over Claddagh and see the sun go down on Galway Bay. You can sit and watch the moon rise over Claddagh and see the sun go down on Galway Bay. On Galway Bay.
Well done, Chris. That's the Bushmills, will you?
That's to be sure.
There's been some nice travel programmes on about Ireland.
It is beautiful.
It is, despite the rain.
I know.
Because of the rain, it's so beautiful.
Yeah.
Christine, did you prefer the rude version? Because that's not the version I've got. This is my version. It was a shilling in 1947.
Oh,
bless her.
I can't just remember it. I'm sure somebody would have been playing it then.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. On a piano.
Yeah.
Tina, your choice, love.
My dad was singing it.
Well, there's one on the list, on the list,
yeah,
whichever list it is.
Yeah.
And
I've always noticed that I don't remember ever singing it, and I just wondered why. There may be a reason, and that's when a night won his Spurs.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
We have done it in real time. I remember doing it. We are
quiet.
Yeah.
Mm.
We've only done it once.
I think.
Yeah, I think we did it once because I assumed
I probably
everyone
wasn't there that day.
Would know it, and I used to sing it every week at school.
Yeah.
And you know,
it's short but sweet.
When a knight won his spurs in the stories of old, he was gentle and brave, he was gallant and bold, with a shield on his arm and a lance in his hand. For God and for valor he rode through the land. No charger have I, and no sword by my side, yet still to adventure and battle I ride. Though back into starry land giants have fled, and the knights are no more, and the dragons are dead. Let faith be my shield, and let joy be my steed, against the dragons of anger, the ogres of greed. And let me set free with the sword of my youth, from the castle of darkness, the power of truth.
Nice.
That was short and sweet.
Thank you. Well, that's all right. Yeah. Bring back nice memories. Huh?
Yeah.
Cool. Back at school.
Yeah. George and Brenda, your turn.
Could I have Twilight Time, please?
Oh, yes. Haven't sung that for ages.
Yes.
What?
Twilight Time.
I can have a go.
Twilight Time.
Approaching.
Twilight Time.
It's just the years. Yeah. The afterglow.
La 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 la.
La, 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 la. A7 and D minor. In the afterglow of day, we keep a rendezvous beneath the blue.
Beneath the moon.
Yes. Wait, I'm never quite sure where the melody goes, but
probably.
Okay. Yep.
Yeah.
A, good enough.
Yeah, if you're in G, that is. Sorry, bear with everyone. Shush, apart from Chris. Let's not do it. There we go. Chris, come back. Go away. Chris, come back. And share the screen. There we go.
And gee, well, it's a bit ambitious for me, I think. Heavenly shades of night are falling. Oh, we can have a go. Heavenly shades of night are falling. It's twilight time. Out of the mist, your voice is calling. It's twilight time. When bubble-colored curtains mark the end of day, I'll hear you, my dear, at twilight time. Deepening shadows gather splendor as day is done. Fingers of night will the moment, darling, till you're here with me. Together at last, at twilight time. Will fill me like days of old, lighting the spark of a love that fills me with dreams untold. Each day I pray for evening, just to be with you, together and last at twilight time. Must go back and look at that middle bit, though. It's not the right melody.
Well, no, second time round, you were pitch perfect, mate.
Oh, okay. First time would have been good, but there you go.
I think it was a group called the Platters, or one of the first groups, male groups, way back in the 60s. I think it was the Platters who made that popular.
Yes, I think it was. I think it was.
Yeah. You having one, Brenda?
It's yours, George.
Oh, sorry, was it George? Was that you? Sorry.
We can't miss him out.
I believe, please.
Yeah.
I wanted to hear you sing that, George.
Yeah. You'd have to get it in the right key for me.
That can be it.
It's you, Chris.
It has to be long. Oh, I will sing it for you if you like, but it has to be in, you know, a lower key than what we normally sing it.
Yeah. I don't know what key.
You'll be fine.
Still looking. Ah, here it is. Okay, we should. Ooh, C maybe. I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone astray, someone will come to show the way. Time I hear a newborn baby cry, or a touch of leaf, or I see the sky, then I know why I believe. Let's do that whole thing. I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower. Darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show the way. Do you know, George, when I'm at home, it's all editing. I spend more time editing than I do actually recording. It's just...
Well, that's because when you sculpt, you remove the bits to reveal what's underneath.
Indeed, yes.
Yeah. I'm not taking my shirt off. I'm not taking my shirt off.
Don't be mardish.
No, I wouldn't.
Don't be mardish. We haven't got much in life now.
We don't want to find out.
I had my X-ray on Monday. And the nurse is still laughing.
Helen, say Helen.
Well, thank you, by the way. For next week, and of course, George is too sexy for his shirt, like we said. we're going to be up to, of course, the 17th is St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, and yeah.
It's Mothering Sunday on, I think, the 14th.
Yes.
We have to decide where we pitch our kind of... you know, things that we want to sing for about mothers and about Ireland. So maybe we need to, for a future week, stick in Mother McCree. Yes.
Oh.
That covers everything.
Doesn't it?
So there must be a wealth of songs that are about Irish mothers. There's got to be. There must be hundreds of them.
How would I go home?
Yeah. And I've got another future request, yep. And then you can pass me over to the next person. But not for this week, but for another time, because like Fool on the Hill and stuff like that, could we have a go at Salisbury Hill?
Oh, yeah.
Where is it? Can't remember what key it's. Oh, it's in B or something ridiculous.
Not for this week, but let's.
Boom.
Okay, yeah, that's down for next week then, Helen.
Magic. And I've had my request now, so move on to the next person.
No. Well, I think Mo's the only person who hasn't had one today.
Can we sing Calendar Girl?
Yeah.
Please?
I love.
Wrong time of year for that one, really. No, this will be our last one, guys. Thanks for coming.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See you.
Well, thank you for a wonderful morning.
Yeah, we've really
it's been lovely.
Yeah,
nice one. Yeah.
It's been a technical nightmare here, I have to say. We've battled on.
Keeping well.
Bring your shamrocks and your Guinness and your mother next
week. Thank you.
Here we go.
Lovely to see Denise looking so much better than she did last week.
Yeah. Keep at it, Denise.
Yeah.
Yep, lots of love to you.
The road is long, but there's always an end.
With many a winding turn.
Yes.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, and hello.
Lovely.
That was great.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you.
Great start to the weekend.
Yeah, it is.
Absolutely
fantastic.
We love it.
Yeah. Did well, considering you had no words to that.
Yeah. It doesn't matter about technical difficulties, does it?
Didn't you make any mistakes at all?
No.
We improvised.
See you next week, gang.
Yes.
See you.